In this blog, we are going to see the process of uploading a PDF file to the server using a REST API. So in our previous tutorials, we have dealt with the DO library implementation for API request. So here, these are the previous tutorials we have dealt with the help of DO library in our Flutter application. And in this particular blog, we try to see the upload of an image to the server. But after this particular blog, I'm continuously getting requests regarding how to upload a PDF file or a document file to the server. So in this part of the tutorial, I'm going to show you how to upload a PDF file to your server using DO library. It is very much similar to how we upload an image, but few people are getting confused like how to pick the file and how to upload it to the server. So in this part of this tutorial, I will try to show you clearly the process of how to upload a PDF file. Stay tuned till the end of this particular tutorial so that you will get a very good knowledge on how to upload a PDF file. And of course, in our next tutorial, I will also show you how to download the PDF file and view in your Flutter application. So let's get started with this particular tutorial now. So here I have provided the basic code here, like a stateless widget inside which I have added a material, app and scaffold, and inside which I have specified a column, and you can see a text button also I have added. So in my application currently I don't have anything, just a text button in the center of the screen. So with the help of the center widget, I have made the button to be appear in the center of the screen. The label of the button I have just specified like upload PDF, and in the on press currently I have not specified anything. So now let's try to specify a method like upload PDF. And now we are going to create this particular method now. So upload PDF is an asynchronous method because here we are making use of a multi-part request to upload the PDF file. First of all, we will pick the file using a file picker. When you hover your mouse pointer over upload PDF, it is asking you to create a method, because upload PDF method is not there in your code till now. So when you tap on create method here, so now you have got void upload PDF. But instead of void, we need to make use of future here, and this is of a type asynchronous. So now let's start specifying our DO library here. So I'm going to create an object for DO so that we can make use of DO library. And the first thing, as I have said, we need to make use of a file picker here. File picker, and here let's try to specify it like result await file picker. So in our previous tutorials also, I have clearly explained you how to configure the file picker. I am providing the link here, just go through it. Here I have explained you how to configure a file picker such that you will be only able to find only the particular files which you require. For example, now we require PDF, so you can just specify PDF in the file picker, and only the PDF files will be visible for you when you try to open your file picker. But in this part of the tutorial, I am not going to restrict here, so do visit this particular tutorial to know how to add restrictions to your file picker. So file picker dot platform dot pick files. So now let us try to see whether the result is not null so that we can proceed further. So once we got a confirmation like result is not null, we need to get the file path now. So file equal to file result dot files dot single dot path. So we have specified result dot files dot single dot path here, and so that we can get the file name now, so that we can get the exact file path now. So by making use of this particular file path, we need to create a file name. So make use of the file here, and again creating of the file name is depending upon your requirement. Again, I'm just trying to provide it like in a default way, so you may follow this particular path or you may try to implement your own requirement. Sometimes you will also try to get the file name from the user or based on the current time or whatever the scenario it might be. So just try to customize this particular file name according to your requirement, or else you can just follow this particular path also. And we have got file name, and now let us also store the file path in a variable so that it will be easy for us to pass to the API request. That's all. Even in the API request, you can directly specify file.path, but I've just tried to create these two variables so that it will be easy for us at the time of making an API call. So now let's get started with our form data, using which we will try to upload the file now. So with the help of file picker, we have got the file path, right? So we need to provide this particular file path to our multi-part request so that it will try to push the file to our server. So form data equal to from map, and here we need to specify the API key. So I am trying to make use of a real-time API, so there is no any dummy API I am using in this particular tutorial. In a real-time API, there will be an API key to make us authorized to use their services. So here we need to specify the API key now. So here I am going to specify my API key. And whenever you are trying to implement this tutorial on your side, I suggest you to provide your API key over here by just replacing it over here. And the second parameter here we need to specify is file itself. We cannot just directly specify the file here. We need to add await, and with the help of the multi-part file dot from file here. So in our previous tutorials, we have discussed these things also, like from string, from bytes. So just please visit the previous tutorial, because in this particular tutorial, my main aim is to specify how to upload the PDF. So here it is asking us to specify file path. So let's try to make it like file path instead of path. And yes, so we have specified file path, and the second parameter is file name. So I think you understood like why I have created variables earlier, so that it would be easy for us to specify it over here. And now it's time to fetch the response. Now let's try to perform the API call. So for performing API call, I am trying to specify first of all variable response here, and we need to have do.post. So we are trying to post some data, right? So and that's why we are making use of the post API request here. We need to specify the API. So this is the API which I have said that I'm trying to use a real-time API to provide you a better understanding like how the thing works in real time. I'm not trying to provide any dummy API calls here with any dummy data. So this is a real-time API, and I'm trying to use a real PDF file itself. And here comes the data. So what is the data here? So this form data is our data, and I have specified it over here. And one more thing here, whenever we are trying to upload a file to a server, we need to track its progress, like how much of the file is being uploaded and how much is still pending, so that we can show user a status bar like 20% of your file is being uploaded and remaining amount of time is like 2 minutes, for example, so that the user will also have an idea like what is happening behind. And without any progress bar like kind of thing, uploading of a file is very much difficult and user may not understand. So here we'll be getting two parameters here, send, and one more thing is total. And based on this, you can do your own calculations like how much is sent and how much total is remaining. So I'm not going to create the dialogues and all those things, because you can handle those things. So I'm just trying to print them, and I will show you in the log even. So we have almost reached to the end of the tutorial. So yes, one small correction here. Here we are not closing this bracket, and on progress is also part of TO post here. So make sure you specify this within the post here itself. So date, first parameter is a API, second parameter is a data, and the third one is on send progress. So you will be receiving sent and total information over here. And what if the result is not equal to null? So we need to handle the else condition as well, right? So if the result is null, I am just going to specify result is null. Okay. And also here I am going to print response dot, what options we are having here, to string. Okay, so now let's try to run this particular code and try to see, and before trying to implement and before trying to see it in our application, I will be showing you in the Postman as well. So this is our API, and here I have added a sample file, and I have even tested it before this particular tutorial, and now let's try to test it again. So here I am trying to send it, and you can see the status code like 200, and also we have got all the information, and the file is also been uploaded successfully, and these are my remaining credits. So here let's try to see in our application now. So this is the output of the button. So this is the output. Here we have got like only a button is specified, and when we tap on upload PDF here, you can see my file picker is now open, and I can only see sample PDF file. I have not added any restriction here in my emulator. I just only have this particular file for now. So let's try to tap on this particular file, and then quickly we will try to observe the logs as well. So now let's try to observe the logs here. We have got an error here. Why we have got an error? Because I have not added the API key here. So I will try to add the API key, and we'll try to rerun this particular code again. So here I have added my API key, and now let's try to see how this thing works now. And this is what the status, still our file is being uploaded and it is not uploaded yet. So let us try to see what we'll get by the end of the file upload. So here you can see, we can clearly see our file is now uploaded, and once the file is uploaded, we have got the response, and the response states like status is 200 and my remaining credits are 434. So previously when I tried in Postman, it's like 467 credits, and now it's like 434 credits. So this is how we can just upload a PDF file in our Flutter application here. And the code for this particular tutorial I am providing in the description section below. And if you are having any queries, do let me know in the comment section below. And also try to let me know in the comment section what are the other tutorials you are interested to learn in Flutter, so that I can try to make a tutorial on those topics as well. So if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.